The world's most valuable brands, 2019. Apple on top at $206 billion. $206 billion. I'm a big Apple fan. This is an image that I drew to visually represent this. And I just find it really interesting because I think Apple does a lot of things every day that we don't even think about that dig us deeper and deeper into this Apple cult almost, this Apple ecosystem to the point where we can't even get out, ever. No matter what.
Oh, new iPhone came out. Got it again.
Yeah, but the new one is way better.
All he did was add a new camera, and you never even take photos. In fact, you always make me take photos.
Okay, but I'm trying to become a photographer. You know that.
No, you're only saying that to justify buying a new iPhone. Your photos aren't even impressive.
But the only thing that's been holding me back is the camera. And you know I'm trying to be a wedding photographer. I'm a wedding photographer now.
You're not even good at it. You don't even like it. Since when do you like taking photos? The only photos you take are of your dog, and they're not even impressive. They're like bad. Yeah.
I'm taking the photo.
Oh, you're gonna come.
I'm photoing you right now. I'm photographing you because I know how to do that.
How about that, huh? How about that?
It happens to the best of us, Jessica. It's not your fault. It really isn't. With the release of the new iPhone 11 and AirPod Pros, which, by the way, why do I buy these? I'm a sucker. These got me thinking about how I literally buy pretty much everything Apple puts out. Doesn't matter if they're better. Doesn't matter if I already have AirPods that I probably will lose anyway. I'm gonna lose these, I'm sure. It's embarrassing. I mean, most of the stuff that Apple puts out is, I mean, apart from the phone, which I think is pretty good, a lot of the stuff they put out just isn't the best product on the market. It's not the cheapest. It's not the most bang for your buck. So why am I doing this to myself? Why do millions of us do this to ourselves? And why has this led to make Apple the most valuable brand of 2019? All of this, yeah, we buy it anyway. I'm gonna share with you why I think we do that. But first, the word from our sponsor. ViewSonic M1 Mini Projector. Interested? You should be. Extremely portable, fits right in my pocket.
What you got in your pocket? ViewSonic M1 Mini Projector, what else, dude? Boom, life of the party, come on.
This sucker weighs less than a pound.
0.66 pounds. So light.
It's got 2.5 hours of battery life, which is enough to watch 7 different episodes of The Office. Or the same episode 7 times, I'm not judging. Loud JBL speaker. Check this out.
Oh, I don't know what you mean.
It's loud, it's really loud, the speakers are great.
HDMI port, USB port, swappable panels to get stylish, boop boop, and a built-in stand for your convenience.
This is a really fun gift for the holidays. I've been playing around with this for the past couple weeks with some friends, throw up a movie at night, watch the same episode of The Office, it doesn't matter. Click the Amazon link in the description to purchase it. Thanks again, ViewSonic. I love you! Woo!
It's almost annoying how good of a job Apple does at creating a community around their customers. I don't know what it is, but even the viral aspect of iPhone things, AirPod memes all over the place. You don't see that with, like, I don't even know who else makes headphones, dude. Like Sony headphones. You don't see that with Bose headphones. You don't see that with these brands. And it's just, there's something about Apple that is viral. Like, people give away iPhones and all of a sudden that video has 10 million views. There's just something so fascinating about that. And I really wonder if Apple kind of starts these memes low-key, like on Reddit or something, has a little team that starts meme pages. I wouldn't be surprised. That's all I'm gonna say. Could be a marketing tool. What is guerrilla marketing? Maybe some guerrilla marketing going on. Just had to look that up to double check what that means. But beyond that, intentional things that they do, which I find pretty interesting. And it's crazy. I mean, for example, if you wanna text your friend, you go to the Green Messages app. And if your friend has an iPhone, you see beautiful blue iMessages. Gorgeous! With live updates. Is the message delivered? Has my friend read it yet? Is my friend typing? Your friend can even like your text or haha. Wow, so fun. The list goes on. Like all of these features that Apple has put into their operating software, iOS. I don't know why I'm making a tech video right now. I don't even know what I'm talking about. It's really an endless list. I think this is probably one of the biggest reasons for Apple's success, apart from a few other things we're gonna talk about. But the fact that Apple has made you an outcast in your friend group if you do not have an iPhone is unreal. You know, other companies like Samsung and Google have their own ecosystem operating software, but it's not as seamless as Apple, and it doesn't feel as strong as Apple, like the community that they've built. Like if you go to text your friend and they have an Android, ew, that green text message, it's like boogers. I bet the name of the color they chose was like boogers or vegetables. Obviously Apple can't customize your experience with your friends without iPhones because you're not under the same operating software. Apple easily could have made the experience the same for all phones, right? Text all your friends the same way, text all your friends in the same group chat, it all feels the same. But instead, they literally decided, you know what, no. We're gonna make the experience for non-iPhone users just a little bit worse. Actually, a lot worse. I mean, all love to the Android users, but I don't even like texting people if they don't have an iPhone. There's just something about it, like I don't even know my text went through, for example. I mean, they literally reward you for being friends with other Apple customers. It's crazy. So here's just a quick punch list of all the extra features you get while contacting a fellow iPhone user. I feel like this is a brand deal. What's going on? Voice memos, sharing location and contacts, bubble and screen effects, emojis and tapbacks, digital touch and handwriting, not to mention things like FaceTime and group FaceTime, tons of things that allow you to just connect with your Apple comrades. I can't believe I just said comrades. And that's a lot of stuff. Text someone without an iPhone, the experience is obviously way worse. Apps like Instagram, we all got it. It's pretty much optimized for iOS. And it's not that Android companies don't know how to do these things or how to make their experience better. They're not like trying to sell bad products or bad operating softwares. It's just that there's so many different kinds of Android devices. App developers don't have the time or resources to accommodate for 1,000 different types of hardwares in each phone. Thousands of different camera sensors, screen sizes, like there's only so many iPhones. There's like 11, no, not even 11. And the screen sizes don't vary that much. So they're able to accommodate for that. Literally, I don't even think we know how many Androids are out there. So it makes things kind of difficult.
That's why Instagram stories on Android be looking like this. And Snapchats be looking like this.
Making sure all of their products work together to make your life easier. Marques Brownlee, he made a great video explaining the Apple ecosystem about a year ago.
If you ask somebody why they use an iPhone, it more or less comes down to the same answer. The answer has something to do with the ecosystem. Apple makes a ton of devices, but what makes this ecosystem so successful is not only how well they work together, but the walls they've built up around those things.
Basically, here's the plan. Get an iPhone, it's popular. Oh, you want a computer? Get the MacBook. You can iMessage and AirDrop, it's so fun. Also, all your rich friends have them. You might as well get one too. You need them to like you. Oh, you want some earbuds? Ever heard of AirPods? I'm sure you saw the memes. Smartwatch? You might as well get the Apple one. It works with all my other stuff. And it goes on and on with like Apple TV, iCloud. Sync everything up into the same place. Apple Music and the HomePod. Like, it's actually pretty mind-blowing. And obviously other companies are trying to do the same thing, but there's just something about maybe Apple's just ahead of the curve or just the way that things integrate. It's fantastic. I'm not gonna lie. I don't wanna say it's not a bad experience. It's just expensive and being in this ecosystem is very tunnel vision-esque. I don't know words. I'm sorry. It never ends. Like, Apple digs you deeper and deeper into this wonderful utopia. So deep that if a better, cheaper product, better phone, less expensive, with a better camera, or better earphones come out, it just doesn't make sense to switch. Like, you'd literally rather pay more for a worse product just because it syncs with your other devices or, like, it works in your ecosystem. And some would argue that that's valuable in itself. That's, like, worth the extra $80 or whatever you're gonna pay for some... I wouldn't buy these, by the way. The ecosystem is what's sells. So, and maybe even more so than the ecosystem, the branding. I said branding. I just said it kind of loud and weird. Have you ever unboxed an iPhone or MacBook? Or just like watched an unboxing video on YouTube? Oh my God. You just treat it like a newborn baby. Maybe even more delicately, more carefully than a newborn baby. I'm talking about removing the plastic ever so gently. Like all of a sudden we become a neurosurgeon, dude. We're doing some procedure. And this is 100% intentional. Apple wants you to literally feel like you are unboxing the most precious resource in the world. And they've made their packaging such a priority and it's consistent. Every single product feels and looks the same on the outside. It's all amazing. Tell me the truth. Which package would you be more excited to open, more careful with, take a picture of and post it on your Instagram story? Which one? HP makes great products. That's the crazy thing. It goes a long way. A lot of tech brands are getting great with their packaging, by the way. Apple's not the only brand that does a good job, but the way Apple has made all of their products legitimately like a family, like the Apple section of Best Buy, it literally feels like a freaking family reunion. It's just different and consistent. And I think that is a big reason for their success. Some sort of secret sauce for brand building, just to make the packages all the same. Their logo is literally an apple. How are they allowed to do that? They just like own a fruit. They just called themselves a fruit and it's like legal. It's only a few brands in the world can get away with just showing an icon and having that type of recognition, like Nike, for example, and just like not having to put their actual name or words, or lettering. And then Apple stores, big, simple Apple logo. In the store itself, it's an open concept. It's like a metaphor for what these products are supposed to do other than drain your wallet. The store is like a playground for kids and adults. It doesn't matter what age you are. You're like thrilled to go inside. If you go on a weekday, there's probably like 2 employees for every single customer. And each table inside has a product you either have, want, or are about to find out about and like try to buy or write on your Christmas list. Like, it's really genius. I think no product really strays away from the same goal of creating like a monopoly on their products. I think that's what makes Apple the biggest brand. I really do. Obviously, I come across as a massive Apple fanboy. I know, you don't have to tell me. I am. There's 100%, no doubt in my mind, a better product for every single Mac computer, iPhone, AirPods. There's a better option probably at a cheaper price. But just thinking about the value of like all of them together is something that, I don't know, I find it pretty cool. Let me know what you think. Does Apple deserve to be the most valuable brand in 2019? I don't know. What's next? Apples? Get out of here. Interesting stuff. Let's get to 206 billion likes. We got really close last video. I like apples. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bang Energy is an energy drink company, but it seems as though the only beverage amongst us is tea. Sis. There's a bug.